is no need to fear. Underdog is here.
When criminals in this world appear and break the laws that they should fear and frighten all who see or hear, the cry goes up both far and near for underdog.
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 Speed of lightning, roar of thunder, fighting all who rob or plunder. Underdog.
Ooh-ah.
Underdog. When in this world the headlines read of those whose hearts are filled with greed, who rob and steal from those who need to right this wrong with blinding speed, goes underdog.
Underdog.
Speed of lightning, roar of thunder, fighting all who rob or plunder. Underdog. Underdog.
Underdog.
It's another DIY project segment. As you can see, we have another load of 18 8-foot pickets from the local Home Depot. And I'm going to pan to the right and you will see we no longer have a tarped area of where the cement was. Now I'm going to show you some of the work we did yesterday. As you can see, the finished product from the last segment will be on the next. Will be on this next piece here. All right, this section here is the completed gate with the sleeves installed, ground level, and the 4x4. Half post. I've got a problem with the right hand side of the gate. The post is leaning to the left, so when I put the bottom stringer in, or the middle stringer, I've got to pull the post toward the right hand side. Now this is what we've done yesterday after we completed. This is the finished stuff right here. That was a lot of challenge, that post right there. As you can see in the video, it was a bugger. Okay, and this one here is what I thought was the corner of the septic tank. We only hit a driveway paver or red brick that goes on the siding of a house. That's the only thing we hit. Other than that, that thing went down in there no problem. Alright, the next segment is coming up. Okay, the next segment is going to be putting up the stringers in between the left hand and the right hand posts. And then I'm going to string from the gate over to the end of the trailer, and then go from the other end over here toward the fence over here. So That's our next segment of the gate project. See you next time. It's another DIY project show segment. Seeing I have a couple of hours downtime until I want to start on my stringer project, I'm letting the quick set cure a little bit. And I figured I'd burn this little old pile of trash, see what we have in it. You never know, like I said on the other video. There might be a car in there. Might be one of those, what do they call, Fiat? Little MG in there. All right, let's see what we got. I figured I better move the car, because eventually when I start spreading this stuff out on the driveway and burn it, I may end up with nails in my tires. So, I had to move the car. Alright, let's go see what we've got under this pile of garbage. Yeah, burning a pile of stuff is like going down memory lane. You find stuff you haven't seen in 30 years. It's like an attic, but outside with fire. Well, I did find one thing. I had an old white rocking chair. My old dog, Dolly, chewed the arm off. It's in that pile. I had a stove hood that was in that pile. I had a ...20-foot dish mover in that pile. I've got a screen door in that pile. I've got an entry door in the bottom of that pile. But we're getting it slowly, surely. I didn't want to burn it all at once because that would have been a mess. Would have been too high, too fast. All right. As you can see, if you can see through the smoke, I hit pay dirt. Back there up on the little hill, I did find my old front door screen door. Aluminum. Still has, believe it or not, it still has the glass in it intact. I'm going to bust up the glass and fold it up or tear it up with a reciprocating saw. Some more recycling. Boy, I'm going to have coffee money for a month. All right, here's a better look at that aluminum screen door with the glass still intact. My pile's getting down there. What I'm going to do is break it down in like sections after this burn. burn half the pile where it stayed, and burn the other half, get it over, and then burn it about, 4 feet high. Keep it from hitting them trees up there. As you can see, the pile's just about done. I'll probably have another, maybe one more burn. And what I'll do is I'll burn the piles where they're at on the other side of this burn pile. We'll see how it works out. Just gotta keep it low to the ground and away from the pine tree limbs that are up at the top. And we don't wanna do that. Okay. Well, as you can see, I've only got a few little hot spots. This pile is going to stay wet. It's supposed to rain Thursday, but I'll wet all that down and come out here and check it around 9-ish maybe. I'll let this burn for a few minutes more. And then, like I said, I'm gonna go ahead and burn each of those other two piles where they're at. That way, I don't have to worry about that dreaded kudzu. Maybe I'll burn the roots out. All right. All right. As you can see in this shot, our pile has burned down. While I went to work on Wednesday, I decided to stop at Lowe's and pick up 18 pickets. So, what we're going to do is burn that pile over there, which is going to be right here. We're going to burn that section and get this stuff out of the driveway. As it's burning, I'm going to take the stuff that's in the driveway, put it into the pile, and then pull my recycling stuff that's on the driveway into a pile and probably load it up and go and get it recycled tomorrow. All right. Well, as you can see, this is going to be a slow burn, but it is burning. There's a lot of stuff under there. Once it gets going under there, I'm going to open it up a little and let some air in there, and it'll mostly burn. Right now it's smoking because it hasn't caught yet. All right. Well, this is burn day number 2. And it doesn't seem like it wants to burn. And the problem is it's taking forever. But that's okay. I'm going to clean up that pile in front of it and roust up some recyclables. And tomorrow it's supposed to rain. So, but this has been here for 30 years. That's what they call in a landfill. That's been sitting there for 30 years. Can you imagine how much garbage it's going to take to break down? 2,000 years. Alright. Well, we had to put a little bit of petrol on the old fire to get it a-going. So far, so good. And it's about 4:30 in the afternoon, so I got about 3 hours. I can let this go, so we'll see what happens. Well, okay, this is so far what I've got scrap that I've pulled out of that pile. And there's some old farm fencing that I got in the car right now, and believe it or not, I actually found a microwave. Well, it's about 5:30 in the afternoon, and as you can see, I just got mostly smoldering stuff, so I'm just going to let it smolder until I take a hose to it. Basically, I'm going to get up in the morning, take this stuff to the recycling place about 8:30, and might run up to the Home Depot, I don't know yet, or the Lowe's yet. But it's supposed to rain, that's why I'm going to do all that tomorrow. Alright, that concludes the second day of the pile of trash burned. And like I said, tomorrow it's supposed to rain, so we'll see what's going on. I'll tackle this pile maybe next week, but tomorrow, recycling day. I ain't got much of a pile left of recycles. I got the car packed full. So, we'll see what happens tomorrow. Alright, be looking for the next segment of the Do-It-Yourself. Project Show. Alright, it's another DIY project show segment. As you can see, I have a load of pickets to unload. And my scrap metal, as you can see over here, has to be loaded in the car afterwards. So what I'm going to do is unload the pickets, load the car up with the scrap, turn the car around, and take it to the recycling bin. I actually got about $4 worth of scrap yesterday from all that stuff. And that drum, they won't take the drum unless it's got the lid off of it. So if I'm going to take the lid off of it, I'm going to keep it. Alright. Yeah, I just thought of an idea. Instead of unloading the car and then putting 18 pickets on the ground and then coming back and picking up the pickets off the ground to put up on the fence, I'll just load a board and I'll put up a picket and then I'll have the car unloaded and the pickets up at the same time. Well, I got the car unloaded, and as you can see, I've got this panel done, and about 1/4 of the other, but I ran out of nails. Well, I didn't run out of nails, I ran out of the wrong kind of nails, because I bought the wrong thickness of the nail.
criminals in this world appear and break the laws that they should fear and frighten all who see or hear. The cry goes up both far and near for underdog.
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 Speed of lightning, roar of thunder, fighting all who love or plunder. Underdog.
Ooh,
ah, underdog. In this world, the headlines read of those whose hearts are filled with greed, who rob and steal from those who need to right this wrong with blinding speed. 'Cause underdog,
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 speed of lightning, roar.